Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all glory, honor, and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostle elders, a great millstone who rule well. And salutations to all you brothers out there pushing this word in love, truth, sincerity, and humility. Once again, it's the brother Shatia from the Chicago camp. Coming back to you with what I hope is another quick and edifying sit down. And hey, as I always say, you can't work in Hollywood unless you know the Bible. And these people in Hollywood, these entertainers, these basketball players, these singers, musicians, whoever, they all watch GMS. And what inspires me to say this is this video that just recently popped up in my news feed. And it's Busta Rhymes' Fire trailer. Now, most people know about Busta Rhymes, old school rapper from the group, I believe it was Leaders of the New School. Okay? And I didn't know this, but he's coming out with a second album. And I had a chance, like literally, I just watched this video maybe 2-3 minutes ago. And I was like, this is a lesson right here. And a lot is being shown in just this minute clip. So I'm not going to do a whole lot of talking. I'm just going to play this video and we're going to get some scripture. Tell you, a lot was said in that video. Okay, now the first thing we see as this trailer from starts is that they go into the 17th and 18th verse, and it's verbatim, so we'll just read it. And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. All right. Now, the men of Great Millstone, we've been preaching about this for years, long before it even became a mainstream thing, a popular topic, non-taboo, however you choose to say it. All right, the men of Great Millstone have been preaching on this for years, long before many people were even aware of such a thing or even connected the dots. All right, and the main thing that we preach is that the whole world will be subject to choosing or refusing this device. And we also preach that this mark of the beast is one of the last major prophecies to happen, I guess for lack of a better phrase, pre-kingdom. Okay, because after the mark of the beast, the only thing that's left to happen is the missiles. And after they show this scripture what do you see for the majority of the film? You see everything being completely burnt to ashes. Let's just look at this. Look at it again. Look at that. Everything's burning. Everything's burning to the ground. And let's go get that scripture. Burn oven. We got Malachi 4:1. And it says, "For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble, and the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch." All right. And so as you watch this, you see that it's burning up a city. And look, you got New York City that they're showing, because I believe he is from New York City. I don't know which borough he's from, but they're showing New York City being destroyed. And it's funny because what's happening right now with New York City, all right, that place is done. I mean, it's completely dead financially. That thing, that place is just waiting for the missiles. And you have the countdown in the center that's counting down to the absolute final destruction, which, in a sense, the men of the Lord, we are counting down to the final destruction. And how do we do that? Through the prophecies. As it says in the Bible, let's get that. How it says that a man should be occupied Ecclesiasticus 39:1. It says, "But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High and is occupied in the meditation thereof will seek out the wisdom of all the ancient and be occupied in prophecies." Because when you read the Bible and you start developing a certain working knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, you realize and you understand certain prophecies. Not only that, you understand that the prophecies have to come in a certain order. Okay? And in this order, you can count down, or you can say, if you want to cross out certain things off the list. Like once this prophecy happens, it's like, okay, I can cross that out. Now we only got these left. Then you live life and then you see another prophecy come to pass. It's like, oh, we got this one. We can now cross that out. Okay. And the more prophecies you're able to cross out because they've manifested themselves, this lets you know that, hey, we're at, metaphorically speaking, 5 more seconds, 2 more seconds, whatever it is, you're keeping a countdown in your head like, hey, we really don't have much longer until the Lord is going to send that wrath upon the earth. Okay, let's continue to let this play. Yeah. That is not a coincidence. He named it Extension Level Event 2, The Wrath of God. Okay, because I think he had an album back in the day that was called Extension Level. Okay, and now he's calling this one Extension Level Event 2, Wrath of God. Which is true, because let's get that in the Bible where it says the first was by water, but the next one is going to be by fire. Because you have to remember, the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, they already did an extinction level event, and that was with the flood. And now the second one, as the scripture says, is going to be by fire. I got to find it real quick. You know what, let me put this on pause and find it because it might take me a little bit. All right, I found it. It's 2 Peter 3. And, man, should I start from the top? Yeah, I'm going to just start from the top. This is 2 Peter 3 and 1. It says, this second epistle, beloved, I now write unto you, in both which I stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance, that ye may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. It says, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lusts and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of creation. For this they willingly are ignorant of, that by the word of the Most High, the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water, whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished. Now they're talking about, hey, you remember the time of Noah where everybody was being wicked and sin was just running rampant all over the earth? He's saying, you remember how God dealt with the earth the last time? He flooded it. And so now he's saying, check this out. But the heavens and the earth, which are now, meaning that the world after the flood, by the same word are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. All right. And what's that day of judgment? All right. The complete destruction of Babylon, the snake. All right. Getting hit with all those lovely ICBM missiles, as we see depicted on here. And as you can see, that is the extinction level event too. Okay. When Babylon, the snake, gets hit with all those ICBM missiles. Now, there's going to be missiles being launched off all across the world, but the main place of great judgment is here in America. As the scripture says, let's read it again, because I don't want to, yes, 2 Peter 3 and 7, it says, but the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. Hey, so that's the extinction of level of event. All right, this is going to be the second time that the Lord is going to destroy this world. All right, not the literal physical world, but this reign, this wicked kingdom. All right. And the main place of judgment is here in the United States. Why? Because it's the place where you have the most ungodliest, nastiest, foul, repugnant, unclean, foul spirit you can name here. Hey, man, this is beautiful. This is a beautiful thing to see, as we say. You can't make this stuff up, man. These folks watch us. These folks know the Bible. All right. And they know that this day is coming. the day that's going to, where the elements shall melt. No, let me get that. Let me get that too. The elements shall melt with fervent heat. I think that's in Isaiah. Oh, yeah. Oh, and that's in the same chapter. Yeah, 2 Peter 3 and 10. Because there's a lot of people that still don't think that this is coming, but it is. It says 2 Peter 3 and 10, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. All right, that's that thundering of the nuclear missiles. That's the thundering of this earth shaking, because you have to remember, as the scripture says, amen, the earth is going to shake to and fro like a drunkard when all these missiles start hitting the ground, not only in America, but all across the world. It says, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burnt up. It says, seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person are ye all to be in all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hastening unto the coming of the day of the Most High, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. And when you look at this, call all y'all by Shemiyahu Shai. Hey, the extinction level event 2, the extinction and eradication of all evil. Man, this is a beautiful thing. This went a little longer than what I expected, but nonetheless, I hope you all were edified. Until the next time, we're to say Shalom.